take 2 points from our seerah today, as we start last time about the Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. And we have mentioned that Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, the father of the prophets, when the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam, during the night journey al-Isra al-Mi'raj, he saw Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam sitting against al-Bayt al-Ma'mur. Al-Bayt al-Ma'mur, which is the Kaaba of the angels, you could say. The Kaaba of the angels. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he created Adam in the beginning, the first time Allah created Sayyidina Adam, the angel, what did he say? He said, قالوا أتجعلوا فيها من يفسد فيها ويسفك الدماء ونحن نسبح بحمدك. They had experience that the jinn before the human beings on this earth, they spread corruptions and they spoiled everything on this earth. And they start like, you know, shedding the blood and all of these problems. The angels, when they so Sayyidina Adam said, oh Allah, you are going to create someone who will make corruption and will, you know, spoils it and start making, you know, sharp blades on this earth. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did he say? Inni a'lamu ma la ta'lamu. I know what you don't know, what you don't know. At this moment, the angels, they thought that they made Allah mad and they want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive them. Then they went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they start asking, oh Allah, forgive us. Then Allah commanded them to make al-Bayt al-Ma'mur, which is the Kaaba to al-Malaika fi al-Saman, the Kaaba of the angels and the heaven. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-Bayt al-Ma'mur fi al-Saman wa Kaaba to Allah fi al-Ard. They said, if Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, they throw a stone or a rock from the Bayt al-Ma'mur, it will go straight on the Kaaba, which is, they are connected to each other. Al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-Bayt al-Ma'mur, every day, 70,000 angels, they go in it, and they worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every day. And if someone is asking, how many angels are there? لخلق السماوات والأرض أكبر من خلق الناس. In Surah Al-Ghafir. That the creation of the heavens, it's more than the human beings on this earth. Then, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded them to make al-Bayt al-Ma'mur, as one of the narrations about the al-Bayt al-Haram or al-Kaaba, the angels, they are the first one to build the Kaaba on this earth. Some narrations said Sayyidina Adam, some they said the angels in the first time, and some said Sayyidina Ibrahim. All of them, everyone, we don't have, you know, authentic hadith about that, but we have some ayat regarding Sayyidina Ibrahim. But when we come to the ayat of Sayyidina Ibrahim and we said, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ, which is Ibrahim عليه السلام and his son Ismail, وَإِذْ يَرْفَعُ Ibrahim, قَوَاعِدَ الْبَيْتِ وَإِسْمَعِيلَ قَوَاعِدَ يَرْفَعُ, which is something exists, and he just again raised it. That's why the scholar said, those who built the Kaaba in the beginning were the angels. Because Adam alayhi salam, when he came down from the Jannah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to take the Kaaba as his house, which means it was existed before he comes on this earth. Everyone has different opinions about that, but the main point is that we have the Kaaba at the time of Sayyidina Ibrahim when he raised it and his son Ismail. The Kaaba was destroyed many times, not just one time. At the time of the flood of Sayyidina Nuh alayhi salam, the Kaaba was gone. And then, you know, it was burned after that. There is a big fire in Mecca at this time, they had burned it. They built it more than 4 times. And if you remember in 2018, you remember when the Kaaba was like, they flew from the Kaaba and you saw 2 doors. There is one door closed. That door from the time of Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Zubayr, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم he was talking to سيدة عائشة. أنا سيدة عائشة لولا أن قومك حديث عهدهم بالكفر because your people still you know they are new in Islam, I would open door to enter and door to exit in the Kaaba. That's why Abdullah ibn Zubayr after Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم passed away, when he came after that, it was in 60 Hijra, he opened another door to the Kaaba and he added more for the Hijr Ismail, which is al-Hafim, down next to the Kaaba. Because this is part of the Kaaba. We will come to it, inshallah. Sayyidina Abdullah opened one door beside the other door for the people to get in and to exit from the other one. Because this was what was one of the wishes of Sayyidina Muhammad to do it. But Sayyidina Muhammad, at this moment, he did not do it. Why? Look at the hikmah and the wisdom behind that. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not want to open door to make fitna between the people. He wished to open door, but he said, the people still knew in Islam. If we make something they did not have it before, now they're gonna start making it. They were fighting in the beginning to put the stone, the black stone or al-Hajar al-Aswad. They were fighting. This tribe said, we are the one gonna pull it. The other said, no, we are the one gonna pull it. Then Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the one pulling. When they said, okay, listen guys, instead of just fighting, the first one is coming, we tell him to, you know, to judge between us. And they found Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, said, alhamdulillah, Muhammad al-Amin, al-Sadiq al-Amin. He came and said, what's going on? They said, we are fighting, which one are going to put this? Because the black stone came from the Jannah. As Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa said, نزل الحجر الأسود أبيض من اللبن. It was, you know, white. فسودته ذنوب بني آدم. The ذنوب and the sins of بني آدم and the son of Adam make it black, dark. Why? Because every time you go, it takes from your sin, you know, because you are a witness in there. And it became like, as we say, الحجر الأسود. And subhanAllah, at this moment, Sayyidina Muhammad told them, okay, take my garments, they put it in Abaya, the one they put it in the top of the dress, and he put the stone, and they raised everyone, take one side from the garment, and they raised it. Then Sayyidina Muhammad took it, and he put it in the place it is right now, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But subhanAllah, when we look at this, the history of the Kaaba, one of the narration, I don't know how strong it is, but we just mention it, but we don't take it as part of our aqidah. It's just, they said, Sayyidina Imam al-Shafi'i, when they asked him one day, Ya Imam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the flood of Sayyidina Nuh, and the Kaaba was destroyed, where did the stone and the rocks or the bricks of the Kaaba go? They did not find it, because they said that the flood of Sayyidina Adam covered the whole earth. Then the Imam al-Shafi'i, when this person asked him, he did not have answer. He said, okay, let me just to go and, you know, search and find out what happened to the Kaaba at this moment. He went and he started like making salah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you know when something hard, as the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana idha hazabahu amr fazi'a ila salah. When he gets worried about something or something is hard, right away he used to pray. Today when we have anything, we need to revive this sunnah. When we are in a difficulties or calamities or something hard, what we say? So, right away make wudu, because the solution in Allah's hands. Right, make wudu, go put your head in the floor and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He will give you the solution. And this is what Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us. If anything you are worried about, right, just make wudu and go. Say whatever you have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will listen to you and will solve it. Sayyidina Imam al-Shafi'i was looking here and there, did not find it. That he make two rak'ah wudu, he make wudu and two rak'ah, and he was asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, give me the answer, I want to go the answer this person. Then when he slept, he had the ru'ya of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He saw Prophet Muhammad in his dream, and the moment he saw him, he said, now I have to ask Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he asked Prophet Muhammad, when the flood of Nuh alayhi salam came and destroyed the whole things, he destroyed the Kaaba. Where is the stone of the Kaaba? Go. Then Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, Ya Shafi'i, each stone went to different places. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala established masjid. Each one of these stones became a masjid. Then Imam Shafi'i, when he wake up, now he has the answer. He's gonna go and answer this person. And the guy came and said, Ya Imam, did not give me the answer. He said, I'll give you the answer now. I got it, alhamdulillah. He said, what's the answer? He said, when the Kaaba was destroyed and the stone, you know, went to different places, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala established with each stone of the Kaaba a house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a masjid. Then the man, what did he say? He said, make salah upon the one who told you that. Which is Prophet Muhammad came to him also in his dream, subhanAllah. We don't know how much the reality of that, but the thing is, the Kaaba was destroyed and they came and built it. Now, when they came, they come to build it. Before Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam born, they were trying to build the Kaaba with halal money. Without, you know, interest, without riba, without, you know, the money they get it from haram way. They said, we need to collect some money. They tried to collect the money. They did not even have the money, halal, pure money, to build the Kaaba. You imagine how Quraysh was and Bani Hashim. As I told you last time, Sayyidina Muhammad was from Kanana, Ibn Ismail alayhi salam, then from Quraysh, and Quraysh Bani Hashim. And Bani Hashim, that's a big tribe. But in the end, they did not even have the pure and halal money to build the Kaaba. That's why you see Al-Hatim. Hatim was part of the Kaaba. That's why when you go and you pray and the people, they fight to go in because it's part of the Kaaba. Whoever is praying in the Hatim, he is praying inside the Kaaba. And the Kaaba, it wasn't like a square. It was like a triangle, the rectangle. It was a little bit long. Then they made the Hatim. They said, we don't have that much money to build it, let's make it, you know, something to complete the Kaaba. Since then, they left it as it is. Then, subhanAllah, after that, they make too many, you know, construction for it. But subhanAllah, when we look at Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, you know, when we go and we find the Maqam Ibrahim, even Maqam Ibrahim until today, it's the same place. One day Sayyidina, Umar ibn Khattab, he was trying, you know, they were negotiating that we want to move it. And the Saudi came after that, at the time of Sheikh Al-Sha'rawi. Sheikh Al-Sha'rawi was teaching in Saudi. And they were asking, you know, did they try, because back then they make big thing for like partition or divider to put the Maqam Ibrahim in it. Maqam Ibrahim is just a stone when Sayyidina Ibrahim stood up and started building, you know, raising the Kaaba. It's there, you go and you see, you know, the footsteps of Sayyidina Ibrahim. The Saudi, they're trying to remove it because he said it's distracting people when they make tawaf. And the first one make tawaf is Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. Then they said, okay, we're gonna remove it from here. Remember Shahrawi, rahmatullah alayhi, he told them, what you are going to do here? No, you're not gonna do it. They said, no, he said, no, you're not gonna do it. Leave it as it is. It's a part of the manasik of the Hajj that we do not touch the Maqam Ibrahim. Leave it like that. They were negotiating, how come? They said, no, khalas, this is. And they, after negotiation, after back and forth, they said, we're gonna leave it as it is. That's why it's still today. Couple of months ago, they were making, you know, they renovated or something, and some people posted some videos and they said, look how the Saudi now, they're trying to remove the Maqam Ibrahim. This is part of the fake news we have on the WhatsApp. And they send it and people just said, oh, look how the Saudi, may Allah take them, may Allah give them punishment. I said, guys, I was there just for the Umrah. It's there, I saw it there. Nothing changed. They just went renovating the place and trying to fix something, but it did not remove anything. It's still same, because this is part of the manasik, and this is also part of the دي عمره ودي حج من وجو وفنش ده طواف انا وميت طولك على الدخان ده مقام ابراهيم عليه السلام. فده هيستوري اوف ذا كعبه از نوت ابوت بيلدينج ذا كعبه اور ذا بلاك ستون اور ذا بيلدينج اتسلف. سيدنا عمر واز لوكن ات ذا بلاك ستون سيد لولا اني رايت رسول الله يقبله كما قبلته. Because I saw Prophet Muhammad kissing you, if Prophet Muhammad did not do it, I would not kiss it. It's not because a lot of people say, oh, you are worshiping, you blame the people that are worshiping cows or you're worshiping idols. You are worshiping the black box. This is what they are saying. He says, we do not worship the Kaaba, guys. We worship Allah through the Kaaba. We are coming here to the Masjid, worship the Masjid. No, it's part. This is the Kaaba, it's our direction. It's our direction. Stone is nothing, but this is we take the manasik of Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam when he said, Rabbana yuqimu salat faj'al afidatan min an-nas tahwi ilayhim. This is the first dua when Sayyidina Ibrahim left his wife and his son Ismail. He started saying, Oh Allah, make it easy for them to establish and to perform their salah. This is the first dua. That's why when we make dua for our kids, we make dua, may Allah protect their deen. Not may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them money or deen will protect them. Money will not. Money will not. The only thing will protect them, their deen. If they hold their deen, don't worry about them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold a firm on their hearts and they will continue. The other point, and I will end with that. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we said, that he came from Naslun Sharif. Naslun Sharif means like the descendants or the his grandfather's lineage. They came from pure people. And one of them is Qusay ibn Kilab. Qusay was the fourth grandfather to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was the second grandfather of Abdul Muttalib. But this man, when I was reading the history and the tariq of this man, he was a leader. He was a chief, one of the chiefs of Mecca. He, subhanAllah, did something we are looking forward to today. Look, back then they used to have the, you know, the racism, tribalism, and they have a lot of things. But this man, when he came, he started like, what's going on with you guys? We have to fix that. We have to do something. We're not gonna leave it like that. He established something called Darul Nadwa. Darul Nadwa, it's a place that he started giving the ahkam, the rules through it. When some people fighting, they have to come to Darul Nadwa, like a court. Like a court. And he started making like an institution for them. He was ruling Mecca for almost 40 years. 40. But he made Quraysh strong. And he made Bani Hashim and the Meccan at this time very strong. They are controlling the Kaaba and the Hujjaj. They are coming to take care of them. And he told them, listen, this is 1, 2, 3. Everyone was listening to him. And he was so strong in his opinion. When he gives something, everyone has to listen. There is some people like that today. In Majalis al-Arfiyah, for example, in my village, we have the, you know, the police department and we have the court, and if something happened, but there is really something Arfi. Arfi means they bring the old man of this our village and they said, you are the one who judge between the people. Before even they go to court. And his, you know, his hukm, he has to be right away approved from even the court. When they get his name and this is what he said, they approve it right away. They don't have to do anything. He was so strong. I attended one day this man and I see, subhanAllah, if this is one of the people like that, how about those chiefs of Mecca? How about Abdul Muttalib? SubhanAllah. The man came and he was sitting and he was just listening to everyone. Look, this is the first thing you need to learn. You used to listen to both parties, both sides, not from here and there. And in the end, with his experience, that's why Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib said, sit with the old people, the elders. Sit with the ulama. Mix with them. Try to learn from them, because they will gain the knowledge. you will gain the experience. Experience is not in the books. It's not gonna be in the stores. It's not gonna be in the university, you know, Harvard or the Columbia. You're gonna find it with the old people, those who have no degrees, but they have experience. And wallahi, when I was sitting with this guy, mashallah alayhi, it's like, subhanallah, someone who studied the whole Quran, studied the whole, you know, law and everything. With his hukm, hundreds of people sitting. And he's sitting in the front. If someone just says something, quiet, sit, that's it. You cannot even. And I just, my mind goes to the leaders of the Meccan back then, before even Islam. No Islam, no deen. For them, just the word they are saying. A man of word. A man of word. When you say something, everyone has to respect. Today, subhanAllah, you feel like this kind of things is gone. We used to have in our houses, in our villages, some people just come, everyone respect them. Today, there's something wrong. What happened? Because everyone think that he has knowledge more than others, and he can do whatever they want. No. The elders, and this is the sunnah, by the way, our young people. The sunnah, as the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَيْسَ مِنَّتْ مَنْ لَمْ يُوَفْكَرْ صَغِيرَنَا وَيُبَجِّلْ كَبِيرَنَا. مَنْ لَمْ يَرْحَمْ صَغِيرَنَا وَيُوَفْكَرْ كَبِيرَنَا. Is not one of us, the one who does not show mercy to the young ones, and does not show respect to the elders. It's not one of us. Why? Because respecting the elders and listening to them and getting the experience from them, you're not gonna find it anywhere. Those people, we need to learn a lot from them. And that's why Qusay ibn Kilab was one of the people who put the qawa'id, the foundation and the fundamental of Mecca at this time, and he made Quraysh to be the name that we hear today, Quraysh. Qusay ibn Kilab. Then subhanAllah, after that, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he was, you know, because this is another lesson we need to learn. Don't be like, you know, you feel embarrassed when they mention your family name or your father. You need to feel proud. Sayyidina Muhammad said, أَنَا وَلَدْ ابْنُ هَاشِمْ وَابْنُ هَاشِمْ وَلَا فَقْرِ. I'm the son of Bani Hashim, and I'm proud of that. Look, this is Sayyidina Muhammad used to be proud of his family. Even they do not accept Islam, but he was proud of the fact that they are taking care of the Hujjaj. And that's why after that, Abraha, the one who came from, he said, the Mecca, they are making money. I want to do something like that. Let's build something here in Yemen for the people to come. You want to make another Kaaba. And after that, he, you know the story when he came with the elephant. I'm going to stop here, inshallah, and next time we'll continue from that. But look here, what he said, oh, the Quraysh, they are taking, you know, they are making money from the people, they are coming from everywhere. Now we want to do something like you know, Bani Hashim. What are you going to do? Let's establish, you know, the Kaaba here. And he was trying to destroy the Kaaba, but he doesn't know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one who saves his houses on this earth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of his houses. But also we need to take care of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maintain it in the right way and take care of it. And our young people, take care of it, because you are the one who carry the flag in the future. If you don't take care of the masajid, we will see like they are selling the masajid. And they will sell it like the synagogues and the churches. Masjid is the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you need to take care of it, because Allah will ask you about it. وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ مَنَعَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ أَنْ يُذْكَرَ فِي هَسْمُهُ وَسَعَ فِي خَرَبِهَا. The one who is so ظالم, the one who ruined and spoiled the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not taking care of it, and not only that. مَنَعَ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ أَنْ يُذْكَرَ فِي هَسْمُهُ. They prevent people to mention the name of Allah, to make the adhkar of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with some ideas in their mind. Okay. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, wallahu mutim wa nuri. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of his masajid. But Allah wants to see what you're gonna do for his masajid. May Allah protect our masajid. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala